Wow, good. Okay, welcome, Liu. Nice to have you here. This is my first live stream, so you are the man of honor or the woman of honor. I don't know. So welcome to the show. As you might know, my name is Rued Riis. I'm a Danish guy, 30 years old, living in Copenhagen, and you probably know me from the channel where I've been posting a lot of videos on Vyond. And the reason why I know something about Vyond is because I used to have my own animation agency where we produced videos for clients. I did that for 3 years, and it was a fun ride, but the success kind of got to us, and I became way too busy, so I actually wanted to stop it before I killed myself. So I closed the company, I closed the agency, and chose to teach online instead. This YouTube channel is a result of that. I have recorded a course. Maybe you've taken it, maybe you haven't. I have promoted it quite heavily on my YouTube channel because I think it holds a lot of value, and there are a lot of tips and tricks and professional insights that we derive from our years of using Vyond that we've put into the course. So if you haven't taken it, I suggest you try to take it. There is a third of it on YouTube. So if you've watched some of the lessons there, you will probably know a bit of it, but the more professional advanced stuff is not on YouTube, of course. So this is my job now. I quit my job in order to start teaching online, and that's what I'm trying to make a living off now. Okay, so today's topic is something that I call the explainer pyramid. I am creating three courses. The first one is Vyond course, which you've probably seen some videos from. The next one is a voiceover course, how do you edit voiceovers in a piece of software that is on all MacBooks called GarageBand. And last but not least, how do you write the script that is the foundation underneath the whole video. So there's the script writing, there is the voiceover production, and then there's the Vyond animation production. And the explainer pyramid is kind of my way to conceptualize. If you imagine like a triangle, a pyramid, where the top is the Vyond skills, the animation skills, the middle part is the voiceover skills, and the bottom foundation of the pyramid is script writing. And in order to make a great video, you need to be able to do all three things. So in every video, there is a foundation of a story, a manuscript, something you've outlined, a structure for the story you want to tell, the message you want to convey. Then there is the layer of the voiceover, the narration, where you use the script, record it with a microphone, or you pay a freelancer to record it. And then you use that audio file to build your animations on top of that. So you see, it all goes down to the foundation, the script. How do you make a script? That's actually quite a difficult topic to cover in such a small format like this one. But my take on it is not very theoretical. It is not based on any schooling, any education. It is based on practical experience from the 3 years where I would actually write all the scripts for the paying clients also. So I was the owner, I was the salesman, but I was also the animator and I was also the script writer. So I have my experience about script writing from there. And there are kind of two things to think about when you write a script for a video, when you create the outline. The first one is the structure of the script. And the second one is the content of the script. So imagine you are to make a new video and you're doing that for your own business, or maybe you're doing it as a freelancer for a client. I don't know, what are you working with, Liu? Can you just give me a heads up in the comments so I know like approximately what your world looks like? Are you employed at a larger company using animation video there? Are you a freelancer selling to clients, or are you just using Vyond for fun? Hellrider, how can I add company logo in shirt or dress? Please tell me. There is a question there, and let me just jump right on that. There is not a functionality to add a company logo to a shirt or a dress. So what we did in Webly when we worked professionally with this was one of two things. The first thing you can do is to just say to the client, I don't think it's a good idea to place the logo on a shirt. It becomes too small, you cannot really see it. And it's not really necessary in order to convey the message that this is someone from a company. So maybe you can create a shirt in the color of the brand, and then you can talk about the brand and you can use the logo up in the corner or something like that. Then you don't need the actual logo on the shirt. So that's kind of the work you can do before actually going into Vyond. So if you convince the client that it's not really necessary in order to understand the messaging, in order to understand the concept of a video, to have this company logo on a shirt or a dress. If they don't agree to that and you have to put the logo on the dress or the shirt, there's some things you can do. First of all, you want to use characters that have actions that don't move. So the thing with the logo is that you would have to place the character and then the logo on top of the character. So if the character moves and does something, the logo would stand still. And that looks weird. That doesn't look good. So another thing you can think about when doing this is to have a character that stands still and you see the logo. But then when they move, they're sideways, you don't see the logo, and then you see the logo again. So that's kind of a not so good solution. So what I would recommend, if you cannot convince the customer to not use logos on the shirt while in the video you're creating, I would go for a character that stands still, talks, has some facial expressions, maybe does something with the arms, and then the logo is on there. Because, yeah, you cannot really do it. The short answer is just you can't. Vyond doesn't have a functionality that allows you to embed a logo on a character so they actually move together. If you have to do it in one scene, you can create a motion path on the logo that matches the motion path of the character and make them move in sync. So if a character is walking from one side to another, you can do it. But again, if the character is turning sideways, you have to also adjust the logo. You see, if the character moves slightly, then you have to kind of turn the logo also sideways. So it becomes like a skewed logo, and that just looks bad. So the best solution I could give you is to look the customer in the eye and say, listen, it's a good idea to put the company logo in the video. Can we do it in another way than on the characters? Because the characters are quite simple. They move around and do a lot of things. And adjusting the logo to all those different situations is not easy. So the best solution, the best outcome will be to leave the logo out, at least as embedded on the characters. You can have it up in the corner, or you can have it on buildings or on a sign behind the character, for example. So those are some ideas on how to do it. Now we have a question from Leo. Hi, I'm an effort to change my career from a cook to become a freelancer, which focus on create great animated explainer video. Awesome, Leo. That was what I did too. After my studies at Copenhagen Business School, I started my video freelancing gig on the side. And I can tell you a little bit about how I did that. Great, you adore me for creating this course. Many thanks to you. Thank you. I hope it helps. I would say the number one thing, the way to kind of move into freelancing and kind of go beyond the vast majority of Vyond creators out there is a few things. The first thing you want to do is to become really good at Vyond. That's a given. So my videos here on YouTube or the course, if you bought that, that's just a foundational layer if you want to become a freelancer. You have to master the tool. And not only that, you have to understand how you can create something that is maybe not possible in Vyond. It's not something they suggest that you create, but you see it from competitors, other businesses that do animation video from with Adobe After Effects, for example, which takes a lot of time to learn, and it's a very tedious process to create videos in that tool. You look at those videos and you actually try to see if you can imitate those videos with Vyond tools. So that's what the Go Beyond Vyond course tries to do. It is, how do we go beyond the functionalities? How do we go up to a level where this is actually professionally looking? And it's not really a question about what tool you used. It's just a question of the final result that you deliver. So master Vyond is the first one. The next one, the next thing you want to do if you want to become a freelancer creating videos, in Vyond, after you've mastered the tool and gone beyond the vast majority of creators and become the top 10%, what you want to do is take jobs, take gigs from your friends, your family, from your network. If you know other cooks or other business owners that need a video, do it for free the first time. I did lots of videos. I think I did the first 10 videos for free. Then I started charging very little, like $50, $100, $150, $200. And slowly I built up a portfolio. So you can say everything in the world, you can do the best marketing, but the very best convincing, the very best convincer, a way to convince new customers is to say, look at this body of work. This is what I've done for others. Yeah, you try to publish a gig on Fiverr. That's like a drop in the ocean. There are so many creators in there. So it's really hard to stand out. But what you want to focus on is quality, really. If you are the best, you will rise above the rest. If you get good ratings and you know how to really kind of master your gig creation, the right description, use the right keywords, use the right thumbnail, make it really professional looking, then you will be able to make some money on Fiverr. But the dangerous thing about Fiverr is that it's driving down the value of the videos. So it's a race to the bottom, right? Everybody's competing for the lowest price, and that's really a hard way to succeed. But build up a portfolio of videos, present those, create a website, promote it on social media, show 10 great videos that you really put some time into. They have a simple brand guide, like consistent colors, consistent fonts, simple actions, a great storyline, great structure with a strong intro, a great story, and then a strong call to action at the end. You have a voiceover with high quality volume, and you have a very turned down music track underneath the whole thing. So that's a great video right there, right? And you create 10 of those, and then you use those as your body of work to get new customers. And try to constantly raise the price. Back when I did it, I was too slow. We charged way too little for way too long. When we got the guts to raise the price, we saw that it was actually it was easier for the clients to say yes to a pricier video, because if you price it too low, they won't believe that it's quality. So if you say, I am a great animator, we have this meeting, we talk for half an hour. Yes, I want to do your video. But at the end you say, yes, I can do the job. And the client asks, how much does it cost? And you look them in the eye and you say, $10. And they're just going to look at you and say, have you heard anything I've said? Like, I don't think you understand the amount of work that I'm asking you for. You cannot do this for $10. You cannot do it for $100. It doesn't make sense at all. So the price is actually part of your product, and you have to make it like a quality product will have a higher price. That's just how it works in the minds of the client. So that's also a way to stand out. People will filter, they will filter the Fiverr gigs based on top level sellers. Do they speak English? But very much also on price. So they will filter away all the low price ones, because it's just not worth spending the time on gigs that you don't really believe will produce the result that you actually want. So price your stuff higher. Say $500 for a 1 minute video. That's not bad. I mean, that's not unrealistic to pay in Scandinavia here, in Denmark, for example. We would charge about $1,500 for a 1 minute video in the beginning. I'll just read a question here. Thanks for your precious advice. It won't work for my clients. Yeah, it looks weird, because the character and the logo is independent. You just have to say it's not possible. We will include the logo as a sign behind the character, or as a watermark throughout the video. Then it's not necessary to have it on the clothes. We will use, yes, you have a blue logo, we will make a blue shirt, and that has to be a fine solution. You also have to bring that confidence, look them in the eye and say, we've done this 10 times before, 100 times before, we know that this is the best solution. You also pay for my advice. So when I suggest that we don't do this thing with the logo on the shirt, that is the best output you'll get from that. So that's also a way to kind of go against the not so clever requests that some clients may have. Hellrider is saying, I worked as a freelancer, earned quite good money using Vyond just because of your videos and official Vyond channel. Nice. If you have some idea regarding putting logo in After Effects on dress, it will be helpful. Many thanks for your advice. Okay, yeah, Hellrider, you can add it in After Effects. You would have to track the character. Like there is this functionality. If I had my hand here and it was moving around, I could include text that would kind of go with my hand, right? So you can, in After Effects, you can say, track this point, track my finger, and then move the text with the finger. So that's a functionality in Adobe After Effects. You can do the same with a character. So, but I'm not sure it will be great. I mean, you would have to have a character and then track a part of the character and include the logo on there, and then they would move around. But as I said before, it is probably the best to advise your client not to have the logo on the shirt. So now I should focus on video quality and skill, Liu says. Yes, you have, yeah, video quality as in the holistic view on a video. There is the pyramid I talked about, the explainer pyramid. You have to really nail the script, become a really good copywriter. You have to understand, for example, I have this, I have three different structures for how to write a strong script. So you can have the fish, the better world, and the USP Uzi. The fish is shaped like a fish, right? With the head and then the body and a tail. Then you have a strong intro where you talk about the context. This is a live streaming with me, Rued Riis, where I will be talking about how to create videos. Like that's an intro, 5 seconds or something. Then there is a story in the middle. I used to have my own agency and we would do thousands of videos, hundreds of videos for paying clients. The clients were loving us and they chose us because we could produce videos in half the time and at a very low cost. That's not really an interesting story, but you know what I mean. And then you finish with a strong call to action at the end. Go to our website, calculate a price with our price calculator, and we'll get in touch with you within 24 hours. That's one structure, that's the fish. Then there's the better world where you have like a before and an after. This is all for script writing. The before is the dark, sad, like unfavorable situation where you say, there is this situation in our company that, well, we're growing, but we're also losing staff. We don't have enough space here in the office anymore. And we used to have all these great meetings and great culture. And we want to keep growing, but not this way. We have to find a better way. Like you create a undesirable presence. And then you switch halfway through, maybe 30 seconds in, you switch to a better world, where you say, but now things are going to be different. We will be moving to a new office. We are hiring a new HR person who will lift the spirit and create a strong culture so we can together conquer the world, right? So there's like the dark present and the light, bright future. That's another way to structure a strong script. The third one is the USP Uzi, and USP stands for unique selling points. And Uzi is like a small gun where you fire away all these selling points at the viewer. And that would be something like, this is our new water bottle. It's made of sustainable plastic and has a reduced climate footprint of 30%. The lid is user-friendly and can be used by children, and the water quality is higher than ever. So this is kind of a stream of unique selling points that you just shoot at the viewer. And those are not very engaging. There's no story. There's not really this kind of a narrative of a person that experiences something and gets like a new insight or yeah, realizes a point. But this USP, Uzi, is very useful if time is short, first of all. If it's only a 30-second video, you cannot really tell a long story. But it's also very useful if you are communicating to someone who are, for example, comparing different products, you versus someone else. Then they just need these unique selling points instead of these longer stories. So comparing products, this is a very good place to use the USP Uzi. Or if it's for like more, you can say, conservative industries like accounting or bankers or something. Now I'm very prejudiced with who I think conservative industries. But if they don't really care about the story, if it's too silly to talk about, this is John. He has a problem. Now he found a solution, and it's a really great thing to buy our product. If that's too silly for, like if you're selling to B2B, business to business, you're selling an enterprise solution, maybe you just want to cut the crap and jump straight to the USPs, the unique selling points. So those were the scripts, the foundation. You need to ace that. You really need to nail that in order to create a good video. It's the foundation for everything else you do. Then the next layer, layer two, is the voiceover. In 9 out of 10 videos, you will be having a voiceover. So you need to master that skill as well in some way. I guess the majority of people out there, is what I see, they buy voiceovers from on Fiverr, for example. And those are really good, as long as you know how to post-produce them. You edit them, give them some compression, some noise reduction, so they sound professional, so that there's no reverb. And then you use that audio file in Vyond, and then there is the tip of the iceberg, the actual animations that you create for that whole thing. But it all rests on a strong script that has been narrated to a great sounding audio file that has been imported into Vyond, where you visualize what's being said throughout the video. But that all rests on the rest of the things. So if you want to be a great Vyonder, great Vyond creator, you need to master all three things, sorry to say. But then you will also leave the competition behind and you can charge 10 times as much as they do on Fiverr. Hellrider is asking, hi, right now I'm charging $50 for a 2D animated video using Vyond, as I do only video making according to the script and voiceover. Tell me what will be possible price for 60 seconds video. I just have to read that again in order to understand the questions. As I do only video making according to the script and voiceover. Okay, so you only do the visual part. That's a dangerous one because it's often not very high quality. You get an order from someone on Fiverr. They send you a final voiceover, right? And you can't really do anything. If you think back on the explainer pyramid, you're already in level two. They have written the script, they have recorded the voiceover, and now you have to create a great video. But it's never better than what it rests on, right? The foundation will always determine how good the video, the end product will be. But if that's the way it has to be, well, if that's the gig you have on Fiverr, I will animate your voiceover, I will create the visual side only, then that's what you have to do. What can you charge for 60 seconds of that? Well, it's of course less than if you own the whole production chain, the script, the voiceover and the video. If you only do the video, you can only charge a little for that, you know, because if they can almost do it themselves using Vyond, then that's not a big value creator for them. But if you're great at it and you're selling 60 seconds of 2D animation, and that takes a day to create, right? If you have to do a good job, you would do, it's a day's work. So maybe that would be something like between $50 and $100, depending on your geographic location. Doesn't really matter on whether you're sitting in Sweden or Poland, right? It's the internet. But you know, if your customer is from a country far away with a small budget, they will probably determine the price of your video. But I would say that you should, if you're selling on Fiverr and that's the only like marketing channel you have, I would build up a super strong Fiverr portfolio. I would really spend the time on creating a great thumbnail, like the thumbnail for the gig. I would get all these different recommendations, reviews, create a great, what's it called, showreel. Where you have the best examples of your different videos cut together. So it's like one fluent video. But my overall suggestion is to try to move beyond Fiverr. Fiverr is driving down the value of a video, but they have such a huge volume. So I totally understand why you're there. I'm in there as well. I'm selling voiceovers there. I used to at least. But my advice is to create a portfolio, go out to your network, create the first videos for free or for a low cost in order to build up the portfolio, throw that on a website, share it on Facebook, LinkedIn, all your different channels, and see if you can start building a kind of just a video a week or something can actually finance your lifestyle if you charge $100 for a video. May you tell your experience in getting a client, how to get a client besides Fiverr? Yeah, sure. Truelancer, check my profile. Is anything extra I can do on it, please? If you send me the link, Hellrider, I'll take a look and I will write my feedback on your profile. I have a lot of experience in web design, product design, so I have a good eye for visuals and aesthetics. So I'd be happy to provide a little bit of feedback on your Truelancer profile if you send me the link. You can send it at, yeah, you can send it in the chat, then I'll see it. That's fine. Leo is asking, may you tell your experience in getting a client, how to get a client besides Fiverr? Yes, I talked about that before, and the best thing is to build up the portfolio, promote it on your personal social media, like the closest people you have to yourself. You will be amazed how many business owners or marketing professionals or freelancers are in your network without you knowing it. So share it out there and post it like, hey, I'm creating video. You actually, two lines under that, you have to become the video person in your network. That was my sole focus. Like, I would always be posting about our new client projects, something that happened in our company, commenting on some industry discussion, becoming the video guy, becoming the video girl. So when someone thinks we should really create a video about how we are going to hire people in the upcoming season, yeah, didn't Leo create video? I think I've heard, I saw on Facebook that Leo started creating videos. Then that's a way to really be top of mind if you use your personal network to build up that that first portfolio of clients. And yeah, they will also be happy to pay you. I mean, if it's your friends or your family or whatever, they will be happy to pay for it because they know you're good and they trust you. And that is the first circle you want to nail, your close network, and then it opens up to the broader markets. Then people that don't know you will come in, they'll see your great portfolio, and they will kind of trust the logos you have there, and they will watch the different videos you have, and it's the videos that are going to sell you. You cannot really say, I'm this and that, I'm so good at Vyond, I'm one of the best out there. Well, your portfolio will sell, right? They'll take a look, they will press play on 2, 3, 4 videos, watch them all the way through and think, is this something that I want to pay for? Is this a style that I'm going for? Yes or no. And if it is, they'll contact you. So it's really going to be two things. One, your portfolio. Two, your logo wall, you can say. So your portfolio are embedded examples of videos you've created on your website. And your logo wall is a picture you create with all the different logos, nicely spaced and, you know, aligned so it looks professional. You also put that image on your website and say, these are some of the clients that we've been working with. That's really just that's like proof of the product. How good are you? What does it look like? And then social proof. How many other people have been buying from you over time? So that reduces the risk of me buying. If I can see a lot of others that I respect, oh, that's a cool logo, that's a cool logo, I'm gonna buy as well, because if they can do it, if they trust this person, then I'll trust them too, right? So that's a way to get started. Another tip I'll give you is to try to be a vendor for other people's companies. So if you know someone who sells web shops, if you know someone who creates websites, if you know anyone who creates like live footage videos, or you know someone who's in similar industries, you can kind of put your product into their product portfolio. So whenever they sell a website, they can sell your videos, your video with that website. So they're going to say, we build a great front page for you. And on that front page, you can choose whether or not you want a nice little video, an explainer that explains your companies to first-time visitors. The client says, oh, how much does it cost? It costs $200. Okay, that sounds reasonable. Can I see some examples? And they'll show your videos and they'll say yes. And then this person will sell your videos for you. And then you will have to produce them and kind of talk to your friend about how it's going to look and all that stuff. That's going to drive down the price that you get a little bit, because they will kind of, they will probably double the price that you charge. But it's a really good way to get some really nice logos on your logo wall. It's a way to get some really nice videos into your product portfolio. And it's a really nice way to create a distributed marketing channel, like multiple streams of potential clients. It's not only you with your one Fiverr profile or your one Facebook profile. It's actually your website friend. It's your live footage friend. It's your photographer friend. It's your whatever friend, social media marketeer friend. They all know you, and that you've all, you have all these partnerships with these guys where you say, if you sell a video, I'll do it for half of what you charge. Or maybe you say, well, I only a fixed price, like I'll take $100 or $200 for the video and you can charge whatever you want. And they'll say, okay, I'm going to try to sell it at the next client meeting, and you're going to be good from there. But again, I will repeat myself, a strong portfolio is the number one sales tool that you will have. No matter how many fancy words or Facebook campaigns and LinkedIn posts and all that stuff, it's not going to sell if the potential client can't see an example of what you've created earlier. So create great videos, become a great at Vyond. I have a course for that. When you are great at Vyond, you know, scrap all the old videos if they don't look as good as your latest video. You're not better than your worst video. That's also a tip I'll give you. If you have a portfolio of five nice videos and the sixth is crappy, scrap the sixth video, right? Because you're never better than your worst video. So take the course, become a master at Vyond, and then start building the portfolio from there. I did it on the site to start off with. I was a student, so I didn't do it full time to start off with. So I built up this kind of reputation as the video guy. Then I built up the portfolio, the logo wall, all that stuff. And then when the studies finished, I would kind of drive out of, I graduated my master's, and then I would kind of land softly in an already ongoing business that I had built through the last 6 months of my studies. So I wouldn't recommend kind of just quitting your job and then starting to build the portfolio from scratch, because it's going to take 3 to 6 months to build something good. Great. Waiting for your feedback. Hellrider. Yes, if you can send me the link to your profile, I will check it out afterwards. If you guys have any questions, I will take them now. I've gone 5 minutes over time. Okay, Carsten, Grafica, hi, welcome to the stream. You're actually a little late because I've been streaming for 30 minutes now. Yeah, you're making money using Vyond. Sounds great. It's a tough market if you only do it on the regular platforms like Fiverr. But if you manage to create your own marketing channel, like your website, for example, it can be really profitable, because you kind of you're not in the game of driving the value of your videos down with all the guys on Fiverr. Can you check my channel where I uploaded my videos? Yes, I would love to check it out afterwards. If you send me your channel link, or maybe I can even click on your name here. I will check it out afterwards and see if there's something awesome in there. So Carsten, Grafica, can you tell us how you get customers? Can you give some feedback on what the channels for customers for you is or are, if you have multiple ones? Are you on Fiverr, on Upwork, Are you building your own website? Is there something that you want to share with the rest of us that we can kind of use to talk about? And also see my agenda here is that I want to just wrap up and say that the future videos I'll be posting are going to be about how to get customers, how to get clients as a freelancer, how to create videos as an e-learner if you're creating for your company, and also for small and medium-sized businesses, how business owners can use animation video in order to promote their products and services. So I'm going to talk more less about concrete Vyond functionalities and more about more contextual stuff, like how to get customers, how to do the marketing with video, how to storytelling, copywriting, all that stuff. Okay, so you are using Facebook boosting, yeah, on Fiverr. However, got no clients yet on Fiverr. Just created gig last April. Yes. And the guys that have been here for a while know that I don't like Fiverr as the only channel for getting customers. I like using your personal network, like your close friends and your family, being the video person in the eyes of your old roommate. He knows you're the video person, your old teacher, you're the guys you used to go to school with, your neighbor, your girlfriends or boyfriends, parents. They all know that you are the video person. So when they go to work, and they sit at lunch and they hear someone from marketing is talking about that they really like to kind of put some motion on the website. They want to give their brand some life. Then you say, well, my son-in-law actually does video, so maybe I can put you in contact with him. That's the snowball you want to get rolling, right? So you become the video person. You build a product portfolio of videos you can show to other clients. Then you have this logo wall with all the different logos of the companies you've been working with, which gives you some social proof. And then you use that to go out and, for example, use Facebook to run campaigns where you say, get a free quote on my website or calculate your price, see how cheap it is or whatever. Then you go into the website and then you see they see the great videos, they see the nice logos. That's where you can open up the more kind of private sphere of clients that you get from your direct network up to the whole world, your whole country. Let me look at some of the comments here. I will definitely take your course. Seems interesting. Yes, I have had 50 students through the course over the last 2 months. So that's really good. I have time to look at each and everyone's tasks and each and everyone's questions. They are answered immediately. And I really try to give everyone a good experience. So yeah, I will be updating the course as well. I got some comments on music and sound effects is something that's actually lagging. So I will be kind of stuffing the holes of the course, right? I think it's really good as it is, but I hear the feedback from you and I listen to that. And I will go into my small living room studio here and I will film the lessons that are lacking, so to say. So. You all have lifetime access to the course, and you will also get access to the new lessons that are upcoming, both on concrete Vyond stuff, but also on the voiceover part, and also on the script writing part, and also on kind of the marketing part, how to get customers, how to build your agency and live a free life as a Vyond creator. Let's see here. Yes, I agree. My clients came from my own country. It's there are plenty of customers in your own country. I would say that it's a mistake to try to go for the world market, right? To kind of market yourself to everyone in the world. I would really, really bet on localization because the market for video creation is so huge. That yes, there are some amazing creators out there that do great videos, and it's easy to get scared by the competition and think that I need to go abroad, I need to go beyond my own country borders in order to get customers. But I can tell you, you will have clients for years and years, even if you stay inside your country. I live in Denmark, we're only 5 million people. I mean, that's one of the smallest countries in the world, right? I only had Danish clients. I had maybe five clients from abroad in the 3 years we had the agency. So there's enough meat inside your own country, and I would say focus on the local market first. Leo says the course is amazing, and I think it's very inspiring that you that how we can use Vyond further than we can imagine. Yes, it's a it was also an eye opener for me that I didn't have to learn all these extra programs in order to create great videos. I really think you have to less is more. It's an old advice, but I really think less is more. So if you open up Vyond and you just start creating, you will create a very messy video. You will use a lot of different styles, a lot of different fonts, colors, effects. It's so cool that they can do all these things. There are this library of sound effects. You go crazy and you build a mess of a video. So you really want to focus. And the first thing you want to do is to have a strict design guide or some kind of visual guideline that you are using for backgrounds, for the texts, the fonts you're using, the transitions between scenes that you only that you stick to, for example, the dissolve or the slide effect or something very subtle that doesn't pop and explode and, you know, split and all these things that just gives the impression of a very like an amateur production. Yeah, and also I think that the general advice about simplifying your scenes is a good one. Less furniture, less actions, less characters at once. I think that's a good way to go. I think I'll have to wrap up the webinar or the YouTube live, the YouTube live streaming now. I've gone 15 minutes over time. I hope you had some good takeaways, that you learned something. Thank you for all the questions. It's been super cool to host this YouTube live thing for the first time in my life. I will definitely be doing more. I posted the date and time 2 hours before it started, so probably I'll be better prepared and get some more viewers, some more attendees next time. Less is better. Yes, exactly. With those words, we will wrap it up. Thank you for watching. See you out there.